Oh. Hey, everybody. My name's Joe. I'm the 3D printing professor, and I'm on a mission. Hello! How much do you know about 3D printing, and would you like to know more? I believe in 3D printing. I believe that it is the most innovative and disruptive technology that we have available in our hands, and to that end, I have created this channel to help 3D printing grow. I've kind of got a three-part mission. The first part is helping newcomers to the hobby. The second part is creating cool things for you guys to use and use 3D printers for, like low-poly dinos, printer blocks, and chibi malls. And the last mission of this channel is to promote the development of the consumer 3D printer market. Sorry, I couldn't shorten that one into a nice little clip, but you get the idea. So that's the goal of this channel. So now let's answer some frequently asked questions, shall we?
Are you really a professor?
Well, yes, kind of. It's complicated. I mean, first of all, there is no, like, regulatory board that says you get to call yourself a professor and you don't. It's a title that really anybody could take upon themselves at any time. So, yes, anybody can be a professor, but generally speaking, it's accepted that a teacher at college is somebody who gets to call themselves a professor. And when I rebranded myself as a 3D printing professor, I was teaching at college, but I'm not teaching at a college anymore. However, I have written several books about 3D printing, and I've got this channel to help educate people. So I guess I get to knock this one back to you and say, do you think that I'm doing enough to call myself a professor? But that said, yeah, I call myself the professor, but I'm still learning just like you and everybody else is. And while this channel is focused on beginners, you know, I do make mistakes every once in a while, and I try to fess up to those as often as they happen, and I try to make sure that they don't happen very often. But yeah, if I ever say or do anything that you know isn't quite right, give me the benefit of the doubt. I do try to do my research.
Why do you wear ties?
All right. That went together easier than I thought. Well, you know, when I rebranded myself as the 3D printing professor, I wanted to have a professional appearance, and I already owned a lot of ties, and I'm comfortable wearing them, so, yeah, ties. Plus, I like ties, and it makes me stand out from the crowd, so, yeah, I like them.
Why aren't you wearing a tie?
Yeah, I can't seem to win this one, because after I rebranded myself and started wearing ties, I got a job at a makerspace, and at the makerspace, I would give people a safety presentation and say, while you're around the CNC machinery, don't wear loose-fitting clothing like ties or dangling jewelry or flapper dresses near the machines, because they will move without regard to your loose-fitting clothing being caught in their gears. Mind you, that's never happened, but, you know, safety first. And so, especially while I'm here in the maker shed doing makery things, I oftentimes took the tie off. But as soon as I did that, people started complaining in the videos, hey, you're not wearing a tie. Oh, well, what can you do there?
Are you a Mormon?
I oftentimes get this question in private messages and emails, and it always kind of comes with an air of, hey, I figured you out, I've cracked the code. Yes, I am a card-carrying member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And yes, there is a card. And yes, I'm carrying it.
You should take apart the printers you review.
It wasn't really a question, but okay, I'm not that guy. I don't worry about what's under the hood or how the sausage gets made. I'm more concerned about how the equipment works, how easy it is to use, and what it's capable of. See, I'm not incapable of worrying about that or doing that, but I came at 3D printing from an artistic vector. I was at one point planning to be a 3D animator, And I realized that I could transfer those skills to modeling for 3D printing, which is why I oftentimes do model-a-thons, where I make a whole set of models to share with you guys, like the aforementioned low-poly dinos, chibimals, printer blocks, and whatever else I might come up with in the future. So that's kind of my focus and where I'm approaching these from. From a less technical standpoint, though I do love the technical and I enjoy going to RepRap festivals and other places where I can see people doing amazing things with technology.
Will you review this 3D printer?
Well, yes. I have a policy to never turn down a review, provided that whoever's sending me the 3D printer recognizes that I retain full editorial control over what said and when it said. Because my priority is to you as the audience, not to them. If I get sent a piece of garbage, I want to be able to tell you guys and warn you guys to do that. And that has caused troubles in the past. But my reason is that I'm always looking for that diamond in the rough, that 3D printer that's going to propel the idea of 3D printing to a new level. But we'll talk more in a future video about my review process and what I'm looking for.
I feel like I've outgrown your channel.
A YouTube channel that focuses on the beginner is no longer appropriate for you? Well, congratulations! You have graduated, and there's a ton of YouTubers out there making content for people who already know a lot about 3D printing. Go watch them. I watch them. I love those channels. I'm going to stay focused on the beginners here and bring them in and then kick them over to those channels. But if you want to support this channel and the goal of this channel in bringing in new people, there's a couple of ways that you can do that. First of all, jump on my Discord. I am fairly active there. There's a suggestion board where people are putting in ideas of things that they want to see. And sometimes I ask people for help there. And there's also the WHATCHAMAKIN channel. So if you make something cool and you want to show it off to people, show it off there. And then I take those and I put them in the end of my videos because I love celebrating the cool things that you're doing. Also, there's my Patreon, and it's always awkward to mention it, but I do have one, and that money does help. Consider signing up if you can afford that, but no pressure on that one. But don't feel bad that this channel doesn't feel like it's for you anymore. Wear that as a badge of pride. You've done great, and you're gonna do great things. Well, that's the end of the video, but wait, before you go, while you're checking out this cool thing posted by one of you on the WHATCHAMAKIN channel on my Discord, why don't you open up the cards and see what deep dive into the topics of this video you can do. And this is really cool. Yeah, I really enjoy it when people connect with me on social media. That's why I've got links to all the socials in the description, and I hope you'll check them out. I've also got a Patreon, which you can check out here, and I'll tell you a little secret about the suggested videos. This is the one that YouTube thinks that you'll like. This is the one, though, that I think you'll like. Which one of us is right? Only one way to know for sure. Gotta watch them both. And remember, safety first, because I really do care about you, and see you next time.